21, I never called them to witness the creation of the heavens and the earth, or even their own creation, nor would I take the misleaders as helpers. 52, and beware of the day, he will say, call upon those who claimed were my associate gods, so they will call them, but will receive no response, and we will make them all share in the same doom. 53, the wicked will see the fire and realize that they are bound to fall into it, and will find no way to avoid it. 54. We have surely set forth in this Quran every kind of lesson for people, but humankind is the most argumentative of all beings. 55. And nothing prevents people from believing when guidance comes to them and from seeking their Lord's forgiveness except their demand to meet the same fate of earlier deniers, or that the torment would confront them face to face. 56. We do not send the messengers except as deliverers of good news and warners, but the disbelievers argue in falsehood, hoping to discredit the truth with it, and make mockery of my revelations and warnings. 57. And who does more wrong than those who, when reminded of their Lord's revelations, turn away from them and forget that their own hands have done? We have certainly cast veils over their hearts, leaving them unable to comprehend this Quran, and deafness in their ears. And if you, O Prophet, invite them to true guidance, they will never be rightly guided. 58. Your Lord is all forgiving, full of mercy. If he were to seize them immediately for what they commit, he would have certainly hastened their punishment. But they have an appointed time from which they will find no refuge. 59. Those are the societies we destroyed when they persisted in wrong, and we had set a time for their destruction. 60. And remember when Moses said to his young assistant, I will never give up until I reach the junction of the two seas, or even if I travel for ages. 61. But when they finally reached the point where the seas met, they forgot their salted fish, and it made its way into the sea, slipping away wondrously. 62. When they part further, he said to his assistant, bring us our meal. We have certainly been exhausted by today's journey. 63. He replied, do you remember when we rested by the rock? That is when I forgot the fish. None made me forget to mention this except Satan, and the fish made its way into the sea miraculously. 64. Moses responded, that is exactly what we were looking for. So they returned retracting their footsteps. 65. There they found a servant of ours to whom we had granted mercy upon us from us and enlightened with knowledge of our own. 66. Moses said to him, May I follow you provided that you teach me some of the right guidance you have been taught. 67. He said, You certainly cannot be patient enough with me. 68. And how can you be patient with what is beyond your realm of knowledge? 69. Moses assured him, You will find me patient, Allah willing, and I will not disobey any of your orders. 70. He responded, Then if you follow me, do not question me about anything until I myself clarify it for you. 71. So they set out, but after they had boarded a ship, the men made a hole in it. Moses protested, Have you done this to drown its people, or you have certainly done a terrible thing? 76. He replied, Did I not say that you cannot have patience with me? 73. Moses pleaded, Excuse me for forgetting and do not be hard on me. 74. So they proceeded until they came across a boy and the man killed him. The Moses protested, Have you killed an innocent soul who killed no one? You have certainly done a horrible thing. 75. He answered, Did I not tell you that you cannot have patience with me?